As a companion to Denis Villeneuve's big screen adaptation of Frank Herbert's Dune, I've been exploring the characters, organizations, and elements that make up this vast and complex universe. With a story that takes place roughly 20,000 years into mankind's future, and largely devoid of the types of technology and computing systems that one would typically expect to see in such a setting, mankind has had to rely on other methods and means in order to advance and prosper. One of the factions which has been working for many generations in order to ensure and even control the evolution of humanity is the ancient, all-female organization known as the Bene Gesserit. While the members of this sisterhood are widely known and can be found throughout the houses of the Landsraad, their clandestine agenda and ultimate goal remains largely hidden. By means of a long-running genetic breeding program, the Order of the Bene Gesserit intend to produce a being under their control that possesses heightened mental powers capable of bridging space and time. This being is known as the Kwisatz Haderach. While I've previously touched on several aspects of the super being and how he fits into the Sisterhood's plans, in this video I'd like to dive deeper into the lore behind the Kwisatz Haderach and the history behind the initiative to produce this individual. The term Kwisatz Haderach is derived from the Bene Gesserit's prescient powers, and a limitation preventing them from fully accessing a specific region of prescient knowledge. Through the use of the drug known as Spice Melange, the Bene Gesserit gained the ability to access other memory, which is the well of ancestral genetic memories contained in one's DNA. However, because the members of the sisterhood were females who carried two X chromosomes, they were not able to successfully access the paternal or male side of these genetic memories. Due to the fact that males possess an X and a Y chromosome, they would not have the same restriction, and thus would be able to access the genetic memories stored within both chromosomes. For more information regarding the function of prescience in Frank Herbert's Dune, be sure to check out my lore video entitled What is Prescience?, where I delve deeper into this fascinating subject. Because of the Sisterhood's limitation on accessing the full spectrum of other memories, this drove them to initiate a genetic breeding program that would produce a male heir capable of doing so. They also would work to ensure that this heir would fall under their direct control. In order to survive the mental trauma resulting from the unlocking of one's genetic other memory, a member of the Bene Gesserit would have to possess and demonstrate the ability to maintain supreme control over their entire mind and body. Through the thousands of years in which the sisterhood has been active, many have tried and failed, often resulting in their death. Gaining mastery over the full spectrum of other memories was only one facet of the Kwisatz Haderach's capabilities. Not only would he have full access to the past memories, but he would also be able to precisely predict the future. In a sense, he would possess all the capabilities, including the ancestral memories of a Bene Gesserit Reverend Mother, the supreme analytical and calculating abilities of a Mentat, and prescient foresight greater than that of a Spacingale Navigator. Through selective breeding, this individual would be genetically inclined to possess higher levels of cognitive ability, enabling him to reach the highest possible human potential. The Kwisatz Haderach would be able to see all possible futures, and through his capabilities enabled by Mentat and Bene Gesserit training, he would be able to cause specific threads of time to be realized through manipulation. At the time in which Dune takes place, and specifically after the emergence of the Bene Gesserit offspring Paul Atreides, the term Kwisatz Haderach was also understood to mean one who can be many places at once. This term became synonymous with Paul, and later came to encompass others who had similar abilities. Paul was not intended by the Sisterhood to be the Kwisatz Haderach, however. Because the Bene Gesserit can control the sex of their offspring, the initial plan was for Paul to have been a female, who would then be bred to a male heir from the lineage of House Harkonnen. Their offspring was meant to be the super being, who would serve as a bridge, healing the rift between the houses Atreides and Harkonnen, who had been engulfed in a centuries-old feud. Through their careful manipulation of the Imperial House Carino, this heir would have assumed the Emperor's Golden Lion throne, giving the Bene Gesserit the control of a prescient being in the seat of supreme control over the universe. The Sisterhood's work to successfully produce this being and to ensure their control over the universe was not only accomplished through their breeding program and infiltration of the Great Houses. Long before the events of Dune, they also enacted a religious engineering initiative known as the Missionaria Protectiva, in which they sowed seeds of superstition in primitive cultures which would grow into legend over time. The superstitions that were seeded among the Fremen tribes on Arrakis had detailed the coming of a prescient son of a Bene Gesserit who would lead them to freedom. They referred to this son as the Lisan al-Gaib. On Arrakis, the Bene Gesserit's influence on the Fremen's religion is so deep that the phrase Kwisatz Haderach is known among the Fremen people, and to them means a shortening of the way, in reference to a prophecy of a messiah that would lead them to paradise. On a large scale, this religious engineering was served to assist the Bene Gesserit in preparing the Empire for the arrival and ultimately help with the masses' acceptance of the Kwisatz Haderach as their leader. Ultimately, the plan to produce the Kwisatz Haderach through the marriage of Houses Harkonnen and Atreides was thwarted due to Lady Jessica's disobedience in choosing to give Duke Leto a son as a male heir instead of a daughter. From early on in Paul's life, he possessed the ability to see glimpses of the future. This indicated that the Kwisatz Haderach may have arrived a generation earlier than intended. Jessica's actions drew the ire of the Sisterhood, but they were still intrigued. So they sent the Reverend Mother Gaius Helen Mohiam to test Paul's prescience, as well as his training in the Bene Gesserit ways. This traumatic test, as well as the Bene Gesserit's compliance with the attempted destruction of House Atreides, only added to Paul's negative view of the Sisterhood and greatly diminished any hope of them being able to control him as planned. The organization's work to produce the Kwisatz Haderach was ultimately an effort to transcend humanity. They intended to work through this being to further their power and influence in order to guide and direct humanity along a path of insight and stability. A common theme in Frank Herbert's Dune saga is a warning against hubris and humanity's inability to predict the capabilities and control the actions of other humans. Ultimately, the Bene Gesserit become blind in their arrogance, thinking that they are wise enough to guide humankind. But without the vision and foreknowledge of the Kwisatz Haderach, they fail to anticipate the forces that loomed in the future and the terrible course that humans ultimately must take in order to ensure their long-term survival. The Kwisatz Haderach, with his supreme prescience, can see a future called the Golden Path, a future which the Bene Gesserit could not have foreseen. Because of this, those who came to be identified as a Kwisatz Haderach would often feel trapped by their own destiny and would subsequently experience significant grief. Villeneuve's Dune will no doubt show several visions of the events which lead to this future, this golden path, and the beings that can see it and have the power to ensure it continue to be center stage as the saga unfolds. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Dune and other sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. And I'm curious to know what you think of the Kwisatz Haderach. Are there any aspects to this being that you find particularly interesting? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.